Hi, welcome back to more RetroNeo Games Plays XCOM 2 The Long War mod. We're about to start Operation Crypt Hound with three rookies. We have Thomas Rue and Jeff Watkins and Jung Jang. They're not rookies. And we have two more rookies. So we're an understrength squad. The last VIP extraction we did, we had six or seven troops, and now we're down to just five, and we'll see how we do. Again, it's 14 turns to get the VIP and get to the extraction. So goodbye from me and my face. Get into the mission. We're at the edge of the map here and here. I'm just heading over the building and down into that one. So it makes sense to take the high ground. Got the best movement. That one's great. How do we get up there anyway? Those pipes on either side. Can't quite reach them. Might be a slower start than I want. And to get up there I need that ladder. And then I've only got a few tiles worth of building to use. The building is either an obstacle or an asset, and I don't know which it is yet. I'm gonna charge one guy.
Rolling out. Enemy sighted.
Right. A lot of visibility and high cover with him, so I thought it was okay to charge. But depending which way that drone goes. I can get one person up. Not you. Right, I can get two or three up.
Double time.
I still open the door. Don't think I can because she's out of moves. Yeah. Someone up there. No good if they come this way, I'll probably just go here. And yeah, same story. I can only get one person up. We'll make that Thomas.
Running.
Now they can get further because he was just in their way, but can't get further because he's now blocking the pipe. Could have. I kind of moved the wrong person because I don't know their mobility as well.
Double time.
Roger that.
Let's see which way that drone is going. Yep, coming this way.
Damn it! Find some
cover. Damn it!
Cover's blown.
I didn't think it was gonna pass through doors. Crap.
They're moving to find me. Need to find some new cover.
Now we've got four enemies against five of us. Crap, and we didn't get to use any advantageous things. Plus, they're on Overwatch. Right. amazing I can do with her. Or probably anyone. No flank. I could get some flanks, actually. Maybe grenade them here. Maybe flashbang. His shotgun will be good if I... Although he only has two shots per mission. But it does a lot of damage up close, so... The only person he can reach kind of is the drone, though. We could take the high ground and start shooting. That'd be good. Oh yeah, area suppression. It's hard to remember who you have on your squad. There's so many troops that you deal with in Long War. Okay, I kind of want everyone to be moving that way, but I don't want to just fire, but... I'm gonna have to, or else I'm gonna take the Overwatch, so she's just gonna have to use... I can suppress two of them. Not that guy, but hopefully I can get the flank on him. Flashbang might be better overall, though. But only if I can hit all three. Can he? I could probably get one of these to flashbang, though. A little afraid that it'll not have the angle, but I'm pretty sure it would. Flashbang, if not, get a grenade. You won't be seen by the Overwatch, that's good. I can't get into closer cover, so... Closer I am, the better positioned I am for a follow-up next turn if we have to. Although she could get flanked as well, so... Assuming we can take care of the drone, then this won't be a flank. So.
On the move.
Also, the drone likes to stun people instead of shoot, but I'm not sure if it sees someone flanked, will it just take the opportunity to... I haven't fought many drones yet, they're new to Long War.
Flashbang.
Alright, so we'll take off their Overwatch. And they won't be as good at shooting next turn. Good mobility. Nine, not great. 75's okay. I think his 70 will go to 80 if I put him up here. 65. I need someone to go start flanking, but... he can... Could he take it out? 3 to 5 damage? I need to... 4 plus 1, I need to do 5 damage. Probably wouldn't kill it. Probably need 2 shooters. What'd she do? 4 to 6 damage. I'll move... Yeah, I have to get him out of the way of the ladder, I forgot that. Do anything amazing with him? Great flanks? No. So even though he's up high and can move far, he won't be able to see anyone and shoot. So I think I'll just take a shot with him on the drone, see what we do. I'm only moving him because I have to get him out of the way. gonna shoot the drone with the gunner. As she will do enough damage to kill it if she hits, probably. So I won't waste, or he will, won't waste two shooters, but no guarantee I'll hit it. Ah. Not great. Oh, come on. Not fair. Only two shooters left. I really want to take advantage of the flank on this guy with one of them. Yeah, I can flank the guy on the truck. But I really gotta get rid of this thing. I don't want to use grenades this early on.
Headed there now.
Get him.
Target down.
Always the last person does enough damage that they could have killed him in the first place.
Orders confirmed. On the move.
Come on. Nice one.
Something over here.
Okay, so they have two shots, but they're flashbanged. What you gonna do, McFly? Good. Didn't even see him move. Damn it. Alright, well, he won't have injuries because that was just his armor getting knocked off. Not too bad. Okay. So, that counts as a flank because he can step out. Or she can, Penny McGregor. Yeah, get him.
X-ray neutralized.
Nice accent. And he'll be harder to get. Might just have to take several shots on him. Good grenade. The grenade wouldn't really blow up the cover, so I'd only just be hurting him and it wouldn't kill him. Can anyone blow up cover? Hacking. Don't think anyone has useful ability for this situation. Okay. So we're just talking about shooting and moving to flanks. And we haven't gotten very far and we're already two turns down. We're about to be three turns down if I don't kill him now. Already 3%, and even if I hit, it wouldn't do enough damage. He won't be flashbanged on the next turn either. So, depression might be good, but I'd really like to start wrapping it up. I can see him from here, so.
Is it clear?
Go there. See what the odds are. 42 is not great. But I'm the only one who can suppress him. Is crap. here and take a shot would probably be a very bad shot, and I'd probably be better just moving to get a flank. Unless I reveal more enemies. No. I would like to not still be dealing with them on the next turn, but there seems to be a lot I can do about that. Assuming all my shots miss, I could get lucky with shots, but no like solid way to get them. So there's no unflankable positions either. Alright. Guess I will move a little. He can be flanked anywhere. Well, not here too easily.
Okay.
Zero percent to crit. I definitely won't kill him. I grenade him first. Really want to grenade the first group of enemies. Your grenade reach, because you had crap aim. That'll only do 2 damage or so. I mean, blowing up his wall would be the best thing, but Long War doesn't seem to blow much up. That might kill his cover? I will try it. Free, okay, but he's still in high cover. For this situation, 41% is kind of high. Damn it! I can't believe you hit him and didn't kill him. Oh, God. I could definitely finish him off with a grenade, but that's, like, too expensive. If I don't suppress him, if I take a shot and miss, he's free to flank and kill someone. Because he won't be stunned. And this guy just won't be able to get him. Tempted to overwatch with him and... Alright, let's do the suppression.
Stay put.
And... move him. No, I could reveal more enemies. I'm just gonna overwatch him. I hope he tries to move and gets killed. That'd be great.
That all you got?
Alright. Get that, but not reveal more enemies. Well, he's the only one on the roof. I'm gonna keep him there. Well, she's also on the roof, but... the dash... Yeah, I think if I... I'm not sure if she can get it if she dashes. Let's try. Because it's on a weird corner.
Got it.
So move her here to see things. Might as well move him then.
On my way.
Kind of surprised that didn't reveal anything. A lot of new view. I move to cover. I really want to keep her up here.
I'm on it.
I thought there was someone I hadn't moved. I'll move him, reload him. I'll overwatch the other two, I think.
Let's do this!
Scanning!
Yeah, I was kind of hoping a patrol would run into me. Alright. Well, I've got this remote scan.
Position confirmed.
See what this offers.
I'll give it a shot.
Nearby enemy groups will be alerted to the position. That's not a bad fail. Small cache of supplies. I'd rather supplies than temporary aim bonuses. Just try. Okay. So, a nearby enemy groups are alerted to our position. That's supposedly bad, but I'm sort of in a good position. For overwatching.
Scanning.
Sort of. Yeah, don't. If I can get an overwatch at the end of this turn, great. But I can't afford the time to hang around here.
Alright, I'll go.
I'm really just hoping that alarm makes them plow into me.
Affirmative, covering now.
Got it covered.
Come on. Good. Bad.
That is not true spotted.
I'll get him next time.
At least we hit it once.
They called in backup.
Oh, and they got reinforcements coming. I don't know if that's if that would have happened anyway, or if it's because my alarm trip thing. 67% to hit, great, but I don't want to be moving everyone up as well. Where's the door for this building? I can get pipes and go down there, or I can out through the windows. And yeah. Bit of a detour to go that way, but. Oh, there's a gap in the roof, so I could go. Quickest way will be up and down, I think. Yeah, it's not too bad. I want to be heading people towards there. I'm afraid of going here. This is the right direction. I'm afraid of going here and revealing more. And then being down here and there was actually more groups headed for me, but I only saw this guy.
Position confirmed.
Not great odds. And since she's at the edge of the group, it'd be wise to overwatch her. got pretty good mobility, so I don't mind leaving him in the back. Well, so does she. So, like, these could, if I leave them on the roof, they could catch up easier than others could. Reload and shoot. You can't even see. Oh, she can. 66, though. As opposed to 71. 2-1. Reload and shoot with her, which might free this guy up. He has a shotgun, so it'll be good to get him close to enemies. I was about to say no more grazing shots.
God damn it.
Ready to engage.
And again, the last guy does enough damage that he could have killed him outright. We had five missed shots on that thing, and or we had four Overwatch shots, of which one hit, then yeah, then two grazes. Sorry, four Overwatch, it's four missed shots total, three hit shots total. That was a and we've only five troops, so that was like a whole turn to take that thing out. But we have to remember that there's reinforcements about to drop in on us.
Is it clear?
So I want people overwatching.
On Overwatch!
On Overwatch!
This guy is really slow, but again, I need the Overwatch. Alright, so we've had our... Actually, we've only seen five enemies from the map, so there's definitely another group. Ignoring reinforcements, there's definitely another group out there. And great, they dropped in on the building.
Advent troops here.
Hopefully they drop down. Okay. Crap.
Get it together.
Okay, they are.
15, be advised, hostile interceptors are inbound at their current position. Firebrand has a
the bad position
to provide extraction.
But if I go here, I can hopefully flank him. Anyone on Overwatch? No.
On the move.
Can I make good use of grenades if they can reach? Oh, come on. Thought he was the only easy one we were gonna have. He'll only suppress one guy. Is that a flank? Nope. Yeah, I can flank the guy on the roof if I'm out of cover. That's not good. Yep. Oh, she has no ammo. These guys are so separated that I can't lash any more than one of them, so we're gonna have to just take our chances with getting hit. Plus, if I advance too much, there's another group somewhere. Could go quite badly. I think there was one situation we had so far that was stickier than this one, but definitely not good. And we came out of the other one just fine, so we don't yet know how this one ends. Alright, you can't even see him, you're gonna have to move. You get a flank on the other guy? Yeah, okay.
Moving to position.
Did she just reveal the other group?
Advent forces
yep.
Sighted.
I had a feeling. A bad, bad, bad feeling. Oh, Jesus. if this weren't timed, I would fall back and overwatch, but this is timed. She doesn't have a flash. She didn't even have great aim on anyone. Bad. What can you do? Light him up. I could use his high damage stuff right now. Oh, he has the walk fire ability. That. Oh, it'll only do half damage, but 100% to hit. Yeah, but it won't kill it. I'll go here, put them under pressure. He might be able to flashbang two of them at once, which might not even save her. I'm not sure if I want to move her to safety or just start shooting. We got one. Well, okay, we do have a few shots, but there's more enemies than we have shots, so that's really, really bad. Point blank. That's not really point blank. That's not gonna hit anyone. What's his normal shot? 75. Not too likely to kill. 71. I would kill him if I hit him. Almost certainly. That'd be one less gun, which is usually my policy, but they can flashbang them, but they'll only be... means I have to kill them next turn. Plus the drone would still be free. Who's my guy that can take care of drones? Or has he already moved? I think he did, yeah. Yeah, he's my hacker, but he's already taken his shot. And missed, if I recall. Which I do, and he did. Crap. Can't flank anyone. I think. Nade. Might be able to flashbang the two of these guys.
I'm going.
Pressing on one, 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 one. There's no way I can suppress more than one person. They're all just outside of, like, area suppression ability. What about flashbanging? The multi-level problem here. I think they'd be in range, but they're on two different levels. Right. Best shot to hit is 57 on the drone. That's all very terrible. 2-5 damage. I mean, shouldn't be wasting grenades, but we have to, like, we don't get the corpse, we might kill loot. Although we're not going to pick corpses up on this time mission anyway. I think you just don't get given them. So she could move and flashbang one person, or... no, again, she can't flank anyone. But I should probably start moving her into a flanking position. Although she would be flanked. But she can't shoot. I can shoot from here. I can't even see what her odds of hitting are until I reload.
Rock and roll.
No, they are all bad. Boy. He's pretty much useless. Well, I could flashbang. Okay, we have all the enemies on the map now that we're likely to have for some time, so she might kill him. Yeah, less likely because he has higher health. Oh, I really don't want to leave her flanked, ideally, but if I suppress these guys, we might survive. And I want to use the flank, but he's the only one who can flashbang two enemies, and flashbanging doesn't guarantee that they miss, but it'll help a lot. I can flashbang. How many guns have they got on us? They've 6, 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, they've 6 guns on us. No, sorry, 7. They get to take 7 shots. And I can probably only reduce that by 1 or 2 now. But I can just try to maximize their chances of missing. Might be able to kill one, but flashbang.
Flashbang.
So now they're only gonna take 5 effectual shots. They got them both, right? Try kill him. Good. Okay, so now they're only gonna take 6 shots, 2 of which are less effectual. She can now. So if I missed, I was gonna flashbang him, but can't. No, she's not gonna hit anybody, so she's pretty much useless. I'll move her up, but can't even get to good cover, so. Let's move here and. Ah. She won't even have support. Come across. Move forward.
Heading to that location.
So now. Could hit and kill. Or it could make more guys suppressed. Tough. I'm tempted to suppress him so that hopefully he doesn't move. Although he is flanked, so he will move. Alright, so that'll just give me a shot on him for 4 to 6 damage, so I might kill him. My chances of killing him will be. What? 22. Plus the high cover will be gone, so it'll be 67. Oh yeah, just 67 would be his aim. Minus Overwatch would be 57. Which is what I have on him anyway. Should I just take the shot? That'll put someone out of action if it stuns them. Oh, anyone in chat have an opinion? Actually, I'm not sure if the Overwatch penalty is 10 or 20, so this. It's at least 10, and if it's more than 10, then I have a worse chance of hitting the other guy, so I'm gonna take this shot. Yes! Finally went our way. The first drone we actually hit straight off and killed straight off. Alright, so. They got 3 over here who are totally free to move. Oh god. But the other two are suppressed at least. Oh shit. I mean, Darn, sorry. Oh god. What was the point in suppressing you if you're just gonna hit? And she's panicked, that's brilliant. Well, there was a point in suppressing him, I guess. But I wasted my flank by flashbanging them and not taking shots, so. Christ. No one's dead yet. But she won't move now. So she's just gonna die there if I don't kill these two. I don't know how likely I am to kill these two. Would have needed her. And I suppose I still can't. I don't have enough ammo to area suppression either. I could reload though. But. Christ. Everyone is so near to death. Now I can't move her because of the Overwatch. 14 and only 14. So bad. Flashbang him. But I can't get out of here and flashbang him, and I can't follow up the flashbang with anyone else. Oh. Bad. Go here. Maybe hit them with a shotgun? I can only get one of them. My grenades aren't active. You can't grenade two turns in a row, it seems, in Long War. 6%! That's not worth doing. 40 to hit and 28 to hit. What's the other thing I can do? The walk fire. 8% to hit? I mean, might. Ah, she's so dead because she panicked. 70. I won't kill him. 2 to 3. I might kill the other guy if I hit him. I guess I gotta try. No. Just no.
Not good.
So, I could get a flank though. Like the best thing.
I hope it's worth it.
Probably the best shot I'm gonna get this whole turn. My god!
Come on, focus. Weapons burning ammo.
You don't see them missing flanks. Them both again. Can we just get killing? 2 to 5. Probably not gonna kill him. I'm probably not gonna kill them either. I flashed them both because unless I can grenade the far guy. No. I can hit him, but I probably won't kill him with the grenade, and then they will definitely take shots on her. This is the only way I could try save her. If I could hunker her. Really wanted her to be the one sort of flanking and stuff. But all on her own back here. I could flashbang him, but then I can't even get away. Because a flashbang will end the turn, and I can't. Can I run away? He will be here, and so I could hunker, or I could try to run the Overwatch, but we haven't had any XCOM soldiers die so far in this campaign. We're on episode 7, but that'll be it. Can I get up that way? I could turn it around if I could get her to hear. Sprinting should let her have a better chance of dodging the overwatch. If she sits there, she's gonna get shot at twice in low cover. One of them by someone higher than her, so Tinker will increase defense by 30 and dodge by 50. Dodge won't help because if she gets grazed, she's dead. Increase defense by 30 though. So her defense is 30 from the low cover. Defense would be 60. So they'd have to roll. I think she'd be okay if she hunkered. But we wouldn't really be advancing the cause. Oh, I don't want to run her. If I hunker and she dies, that'll be such a waste. And we can't even clear these guys. It'll take a go to clear these guys, so we can't sweep in to her rescue for a while either. We'd be doing a lot of hunkering, just getting shot at. Whereas I could break the cycle by getting out here. Chat, advice. We just pray to our Lord Solomon. Trust in random number, or in Jesus. Random number generator, Jesus.
I don't know.
Flip a coin. No, I won't. I'm gonna go by the book. Please don't make me regret that. I respect my XCOM soldiers' lives. Oh, I forgot there was a third guy here who could take a third shot. Oh, but he chose to waste it by just moving a lot. Please miss. Great, they're moving for flanks. Overwatch, alright. He flanked himself, that's weird. Okay, good, he missed. But they still have a shot on her. Right, they've both flanked themselves, that's really unusual. Oh, thank god, flashbanging worked to save her life. So far.
Taking fire over here.
Okay. That was a freebie. We lost the loot, but everyone's still alive. Okay, so I think I'm gonna walk up here and shotgun him right in the face. Sick of their nonsense. We've only got 6 goes to finish the mission as well, which is probably doable, but definitely pushing it. Alright, so she won't do enough damage, but together they'll probably do enough damage to kill him. Can't flank him, he's the only one who can get the flank over here. Which we really need. These guys had ammo, right? You got ammo. You've got ammo. He doesn't have ammo, but he has ammo in his shotgun. Can I get a flank anywhere? No. Oh, wait. Yes. But if I do, I will be flanked. But now she could flashbang 2 guys at once. Okay. I still have a feeling I'm gonna lose Alicia. Ferrari. Ricky Ferrari. But he's only overwatching, so if I don't move, he has to. Oh, he could flank her, maybe. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I think he can flank her. Alright, get going.
On my way.
Percent to hit. Definitely gonna kill him. This way, no. 0. Okay. Well, get him. Brutal. Now I wanted to use the shotgun on the officer, because of the damage it does, but he was the only one who could flank this guy in high cover. Run her up to there. Up to there, yeah. I doubt... Not neither of them better miss, but... Or maybe I should grenade first. Be sure that I do enough damage that I can hit him. Aim is 72. Her aim is 66. So I want her to grenade and him to shoot, probably. Good miss, though. Oh yeah, he can't grenade anyway. This turn.
That's affirmative.
88 to hit, 3 to 5. Actually, maybe I should just shoot. If I get to crit, I'll kill him, and then I get to finish off with a grenade. That might cost loot or something, but this is about saving lives, damn it. Because if I can take shots with her over here, or, you know, to start moving her closer, that will be better for Ferrari. Alright, shoot. Yes!
Good riddance. Running dry on ammo.
Okay. So now, she's a great mover. I could set up for a flank or just get in and can't really cause any damage. Can't get in anywhere really painful. Plus she's only got one health. That would be a flank, but she's only got the one health, so... He can grenade and flash. But he could probably kill, so probably what I'll do. He flashed the other guy. Yeah, she could flash him. But possibly might flash both these and the other guy, which should keep everyone alive even longer. But that's assuming three shots miss her. Probably a lot to assume, considering... Well, she was flanked when they hit her. I'm not sure how much aim a flashbang takes away. Oh, bother. Okay. Should I be sprinting in here? I'm glad he came down off the roof, though. If I go here, this guy might flank him on the next turn, even flashbanged. He shouldn't expose himself to a flank, like coming out here, but they did over here, they exposed themselves.
Right. All right, I'll go.
Seventy-two only. I've got a feeling this is the time we'll miss. I could flash, but could be the time they hit and everyone near them is low on health.
Blinded him.
This is what it's for. Flashbangs have worked pretty well so far.
Need a light?
We're gonna be all out of flashbangs though. So with her I can overwatch? Not sure if I wanna just overwatch or if I wanna get really close without them knowing. I get her up here, she can flank anyone on the next turn. Probably better than just overwatching. Jump down in here. Yeah. Even though she'd be out of cover, I think they'll just move to cover in here.
I'm all over it.
Well, she's dodged a lot of bullets so far and got hit by a few. Oh, good, he's burning. Be great if he panicked. Miss. Good.
I'm pinned down here.
Miss, please. Good. Although he blew the wall out.
Hey, coming over here.
You're on fire. Please miss. Oh, he just made two moves. That's great. Maybe he's panicked. Okay. Maybe we'll get this. I can get in, get flanks on most people. He can flank. Yeah. Oh, there's no grenade. Why can't I grenade? Oh, she grenaded last time. Hope to God she can hit that. He's the only one who will be able. Please. Oh, God. We need to end this. Ow. Afraid that she just won't do enough damage. Might kill that guy. Actually, burning should kill that guy if I can hit him. This guy just can't get in to get a shot. Very unfortunate. Neither can he, of course. And we're so running out of time. So much trouble. Like, we're close to winning, but it could all fall apart. But we can only take two more shots, and there's three enemies. We do have one grenade. Won't be able to shoot anywhere. You should probably start freeing dudes. Although I really want the hacker to be the one freeing. Because he could possibly get us a bonus. Seems silly to be talking about bonuses. We're just trying to survive here, but. Oh boy. For a grenade. Grenades doing damage of 2 to 5 is just not great. Can't really get into good cover and still hope to hit. If I go here, that guy can flank. Actually, oh, they can all flank. Gotta get in, mix it up. Still might lose someone. My weakest guys are the ones in position. Also, they're all about to run out of ammo, so if they don't kill and miraculously survive the turn, then they won't be able to move out of the flanks they're gonna be in and shoot. So, all bad, all bad. I've only 67. Why is it so bad against him? them closer with the weapon? Oh, I get a weapon range bonus when they're further away. Range. Get you in. Add up what you can do. Might just get her to grenade. Sure damage. 82 is pretty good, but probably won't kill. 72 is not bad, but probably won't kill. Boy. I could run up here and scare him, but do anything more useful than that. In this, for all my way my luck's going, they'll probably bring in reinforcements. Like next turn, it'll say reinforcements incoming. 35, 4 to 6 down. 67, 2 to 1 to hit. Probably would kill him. Yes.
There you
Thank
go.
God. So do I shoot or just grenade? Probably just grenade. Be as safe as we can.
Fire in the hole.
And he's not dead. I think the burning will get him. I hope. Can you do anything useful? Go here, and if he's scared enough to run back this way, I could possibly overwatch him. No, I can't, because I need to reload, move, and overwatch. Crap. This guy. I mean, I just don't have time to get that. Gotta move this guy and be ready to hack the doors. In which case, this guy has to get up the ladder first. Probably just reload.
Absolutely.
And you get moving.
Go, go, go.
Pray for your sisters and brothers on the other side of the building. Good, the burning got him. Now he's not disoriented anymore. He's flanked, so he'll move. Oh, now he's flanking us. Miss her, please. No!
Eva, we need emergency.
Oh, crap.
No, damn it, now!
I don't have a medkit. And yep, I told you, they are bringing in reinforcements. Crap. So, I think I'm just gonna move and grenade him.
I hope it's worth it.
I won't even have ammo to take on the next guys. Oh, can I not grenade him? No, I can. Kill that guy. We've suffered our first casualty. She did amazing work. She took a lot of damage when she panicked, so that'd be a lesson to you. Don't panic.
Understood. Moving out.
Open those doors.
Accessing system.
That's not usually that's half as likely as this. One new rebel joins the Haven. Can't remember what region we're in. I think we're in a region that has more than enough rebels though. I mean, that'd be worth some intel. Great! We're gonna save some intel in the future. Not a bad thing at all. That's the reason I wanted him to do the door opening. Anyone could have opened it, but he's probably the only one who would have gotten a bonus. Proceed to the extraction point. Okay. So, head out that way? Where's the door? I have no idea where the reinforcements are coming in, but I kinda just want to get this guy out of here. They shouldn't be overwatched, but I don't think he'll make it on the next turn, so maybe I shouldn't just charge him out there. Maybe I should go nearer the door in here, come out that way. We got 4 turns to do it though. If I go here, he'll kinda be on his own. No idea where they're gonna come in, and I'm pretty much only gonna get one overwatch. Everyone else is panicked or otherwise being stupid. We're dead. That's what I meant by otherwise being stupid. Apparently, just when I did a mental tally. Couldn't have been 3. Okay, they're on the roof. Oh boy. Didn't even get the kill. That's gone. Menace 1-5, hostile interceptor. She's not dead, she's bleeding out, but I can't rescue her. Oh wait, I could pick her up, but... Damn, I forgot that in XCOM 2 you could pick up guys, but... No, I won't be able to walk far enough in 2 turns. Definitely gonna die. So close. Alright, I still have my amazing shotgun. Probably kill him. And I have a fair bit of health that I might survive the revenging that they do. 4 enemies and I've only got 1 person who can really engage. I think. Oh, I could get him up for a grenade maybe. I'm not sure if I can throw a grenade from there to here. I possibly can. But then, can I get all the way over there in 2 turns? Probably not. Come on, make great things happen with your grenade. Alright, we can take him out. Probably take him out, but it's not a guarantee. But he is closer. Therefore, he's dangerous.
Heading out.
Take it. Get him out of here. Well out of here. That was great. What did I expect? Okay, so... guy... he's just gonna have to sprint if he wants to live. Got no... well, he can have a grenade on the next turn, but... there's no point in reloading. Also, his health is super low. Haven't saved in a while. I do just want to see if his movement mobility is reduced when he's carrying her. I'm just gonna like go here, pick her up and end the turn and see what his mobility is. I want to make sure that I'm right about that mechanic. So let's see. Normally do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Is that 8? I think that's just 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. No, we can do 8. He's gonna be dead anyway, but I wanna know for the mechanic for future judgment calls. And you are just... Well, I'm not really playing the turn this time. She runs fast enough that she might make it, but she'd not have panicked if she wanted to definitely live.
On the move.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not really playing the turns right now. Would he make that in 2 turns? Probably. Of course, I'm about to redo all this anyway. I don't want my machine gunner to die for no reason. Hey, wait, where'd the other guy go? Oh, right, no one can see him now, but he was here. Yeah. So I'm pretty much just trying to see the mobility thing. Oh, you are screwed. Alright, so he's not dead, so we can still see the mobility thing. Oh, well, maybe not. You know, that sort of saves everyone else. Horrible as that is. Everyone else would probably make it. How do I be? I'm trying to think if I can reload and see the mechanic without him dying too early. Pretty sure it did slow them down. I'm just gonna... Next time it's a question, I'll test it, I guess.
Roger that.
XCOM, we are leaving.
I'm all over it. Absolutely.
Kill him! Always with the grazing, it's so annoying. Great.
I'm taking fire.
Well, can he make it to the extraction zone? He can.
Get to the evac point now.
So he's allowed to shoot and then move. So I guess I might as well do that on him. No one else can do it. Try take the Overwatch off.
Come on, focus.
Anyone else have really high health that can draw an Overwatch? What am I saying? No one has really high health except him anymore. Well, at least it only went on the armor.
getting it done.
That was a rough mission.
VIP secure and in position for evac.
Very, very rough.
VIP is secure.
Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
Who died? One of them was a rookie, but the other was a gunner. Acceptable, yeah. Boy. That was tough. Very empty Sky Ranger. Though, still completed the mission, but that was our first two casualties. And it all went wrong when we drew two squads at once. Pretty much flanked. Or you could argue that it went wrong when we entered a mission with only five soldiers. Two of whom were rookies. None of whom were snipers. Or you could argue it went wrong when we revealed an enemy drone. Or when an enemy drone flanked us at the end of the first turn. Blowing our ambush overwatch ability and then putting us in a long battle against three enemies in high cover. And that was just the first group. And nothing particularly went right except a couple of shots that we managed to hit and a couple of times where Overwatch didn't kill us, but the Ferrari survived, which I didn't expect. Wounded for 20 days. But, McGregor got two kills. She was flanked, she survived until the very end when she was flanked again. All because Ferrari's shot grazed the guy who killed her and he got away and flanked her and killed her. Which then panicked Ferrari, and Ferrari barely made it out. She only managed to escape because she has huge mobility. Watkins did okay, missed a few shots, but got a few kills, and he looks pretty happy. Rue, he's doing well, I guess, but there will be more casualties to follow, but those are our first two for XCOM. A squaddy and a rookie. Could be worse. Could have been a higher ranked soldier, although pretty much everyone's a squaddy so far. Alright, we got advanced perception. We also lost two or three of the loots. Focus and advanced perception. Better aim. Probably put it on a sniper. Better will. We're a long way, in long war it's even further, but we're a long way from having psychics. And we got a VIP, but is that a scientist? Looks like a scientist. Yeah. We did need a scientist. We have one scientist in the AWC, making sure everyone heals up twice as fast. Other scientists will speed up research. And also unlocks.
Research is proceeding as planned, Commander. Commander, with the admin officer currently in cold storage, we should perform the autopsy as soon as possible.
What are we researching at the moment? Resistance radio. Probably can't afford to build that for a while. 6 days for that. 12 days for this, but how many do I have? 86. Maybe I could build. I'll keep going with the radio towers because I think I can build one and they're valuable.
Well-trained enemy, and yet they never waver in their loyalty to the cause.
Yeah.
Hey, Commander.
How are we doing here? We're working.
I got a report of some creaking down by the aft lift yesterday. I just hope it's not metal fatigue.
I'm sure it's not metal fatigue, Ori. Turn the game volume up a little. Okay. Scanning, is there anything? Can't make contact, don't have enough intel. No other missions on the board, so we're just scanning. Now there's missions on the board straight away. Operation Knife Star. Sabotage the Advent Monument, okay. So that was only the first mission in normal XCOM 2, but now I guess it's just an available mission type. Kind of cool. We'll only get intel out of it. Baseline resistance is extremely light. By which they mean, like, 8 enemies and 2 waves of reinforcements, but not of high tier, low level enemies. So we'll do that.
Setting course for the Indian Regional Zone.
Oh, the mission expires in 19 hours. What? That only just popped up. How could I possibly do this? I mean, you're allowed to do them early. This is my ace squad. Should I? This is a case where I really want to save it and try it out and just be... Like, it's only for 35 intel, I might as well ignore the mission, but I kind of want to see what happens in it. It's not great for a let's play to be like, oh, we'll go back and not... You know, I've gone back one turn sometimes to just test out new long war weapons. To see how they work. So I know how to use them, but not really sure I want to do it with a whole mission. Total infiltration, 4 days, 12 hours, so it'd be... Got all our best stuff. But it's supposed to be very punishing if you do the mission before it's infiltrated. So my inclination would definitely be to skip this mission. But I just want to see how badly Long War punishes you for doing a mission early. But I'm not too keen on losing my entire A squad. So just gonna start the mission and probably... I'm trying to show off the Long War, but I really would feel bad about reloading out of an entire mission. See how it goes, but I'm reserving the right to quit on the mission. And reload to this point where I'm... Yeah, you get it. Start infiltration, 11 hours, we're gonna be like no percent of the way there. So I could... 10 hours until launch. Yeah, see right now it says impregnable. I mean, that's a great reason not to do that mission. Can't even boost infiltration because I don't have enough intel. So, alright, let's just scan and see what it says once it's doing the
setting course for sector 14, East Asia.
And the best B squad we have. Oh, Phil. Too long. We don't need you. Probably, hopefully. Sniper. Not sure what all the buttons are. Total infiltration, 5 days, 20 hours. Infiltration 10. I don't want to send all my best people, you know? He's a shotgunner. What is that class called? Tell me. I want to tell me. Alright, well, he's the close range stun shotgun guy. This is. Oh, he's the guy we just used. We need the promotion, actually. So I can turn him into a medic. Or have this. You know, on that last mission, it would have been quite handy to be able to shock an enemy with guaranteed damage. Medical protocol gives an extra medkit and allows the medkit to be used remotely. Hard to say. Can't remember. I think I had. God damn it. I think I had one on the medic path already and one on the hacking path already. Not sure though. And what do? You're got a machete, right? So I'm kind of. I know you're the gunner type guy that we used a lot on the last mission. Different person, but a same class. Yeah, the point blank shotgun thing. I don't need two shotgun dudes. Or actually, maybe I do. You know what? Just go. We're still possibly reloading the last mission anyway, so. Start the infiltration. Yep. And. So this is now expiring, and it says impregnable. But you know what? This is gonna be our. I just want to see and show on stream what impregnable is, but I'm definitely not launching that mission. This is like a alternate timeline we're about to do for a few minutes. Impregnable. Did I spell that right? I think so. Alright, so let's see how punishing Long War makes an impregnable mission, because as a sensible XCOM commander, I would not launch one. But let's just see more of Long War. So this isn't an Iron Man playthrough, this is let's look at more Long War mechanics. So I don't know if they're going to give us loads of lower tier enemies, or are they going to start introducing higher tier enemies now? Neutralize any hostile contacts and secure the site. So boned. I wonder, this is probably just the first map from the normal game. It's probably a custom map, because that one was never auto-generated. It's always the same. So whenever this mission comes up in Long War, it's probably the exact same type of map. So let's just learn what impregnable means and then reload. Like, not. If you want to follow. Actually, how long are we streaming? An hour and a half so far. This can only take 10 or 15 minutes, I'm sure. Unless we do really well, but. I'm assuming we're just gonna get our asses kicked and reload. Just showing off what Long War impregnable means, because most people are probably gonna avoid that forever. I was gonna say that if you want to just follow the canon timeline of our playthrough, then maybe skip to the next episode, but yeah, maybe just look forward on the video and see if I go back to the base, because I was thinking I'd stream for another hour and this won't take that long. X4 charges at the designated position. And if we call for extraction, it's 6 turns away. And I think once you call for extraction, it blows your cover. Oh! Gonna be a disaster, let's go.
On my way!
spotted already. I thought it would spot along here. I'm just being super reckless. Five at once. Okay. Not great for the sniper. Not terribly impressed. Though no one can see her directly, so I'm just gonna shoot. That's okay. Didn't kill them. I wonder, actually. I wouldn't have dashed up here, but I mean, I said I'd reload this, but I'm really tempted to just beat it. I thought it would just be a group of mutons or something when it said impregnable. I'm tempted to go with it, but yeah, I already pretty much said I wouldn't. I'd rather be a liar. I'm also afraid to hop down here, because if it's impregnable, meaning large numbers of enemies, actually, this is a custom map. Yeah, if it's impregnable, meaning large numbers of enemies, then anywhere I go, I'm probably going to reveal people. But if it's impregnable, meaning mutons, then they should be safe enough to move without revealing more people at once. But I mean, a group of five, that's a good hint that we're talking about numbers. What can you do with flames? Flame two of them, actually. And I have two flamethrowers, and I so rarely get to use it. Two flame ammos. Although she might be the only one who can reach back here. Kill those pesky civilians who always tell on us. Who are buying into the propaganda. They disgust me. Damage 2 to 5. I hate that the flamethrower can do so little damage. Based on luck.
Killing it with fire.
That's terrible. I expected to clear them out there. Here and do an overwatch for him. Probably reveal more enemies, which is no, okay.
Overwatch.
47. I might kill him. I hit him, I will. Oh, he could flank. Let's see, he's the anti-drone guy. Is he a medic? Yeah, he's a medic.
Who
could
there?
Smoke us? Oh, did I? I moved to the wrong place. I meant to move there so I could flank him. Shoot him. Hoping that. Alright, he's burning. Is the other guy? Oh, the other guy's dead. So I'm hoping the flames kill him before he gets to do anything. He ate him. He'll run, so if I overwatch him, I might get him. Two shots left, okay. Probably hit him. Great! Then you can only smoke two. A huge point. Overwatch as well. Yeah, flame got him. So we took down 3 out of 5 on one turn. But the question is, how many enemies does Impregnable mean? I think it's like 20 or 30, if I'm remembering correctly.
Damn it.
Great. Even though the animation hit the wall for sure, I had a feeling it would kill him. So great.
That was close.
Okay.
Anyone flank him, please? No. Not yet, anyway.
I'm trusting you here.
I think that's revealed more enemies. No. This is a frame rate drop.
Heading out. Got some admin here.
Yep. Yeah, so Impregnable just definitely means just tons and tons of enemies. Oh, that's not good. He's flanked now.
Wow.
Could flash to bang them all, but probably better just to move to cover.
On my way.
Pretty good chance to kill him. Might as well. Great. And I think she gets a free move now. Yeah, death from above. You can either reload or move to cover. I don't see them coming within her sight range, so I'm gonna reload. Also, this is just our fast and loose alternate timeline anyway. Just to see how impregnable really is. Just so we know. Great. Might as well keep my aim bonus on height, but I could take high cover instead of aim bonus. And actually, with a lot of guns pointing at me, maybe I should take high cover. Although, if I go over here, I'll probably reveal more enemies. Nice one.
There you go.
Unexpected, but
gonna need a reload soon.
thinking she should just drop a rocket or something at them. Although this 2-7 is not great. And the scatter is, I'm not sure how the rockets work, because they don't work, they certainly don't work the same. Max scatter 2 tiles. I think that means it could go 2 left, or 2 right, or 2 back, or 2 forward. But earlier, in an earlier mission, I used the rocket launcher and it just didn't enter a building. It just impacted the edge of the building and effectively exploded very far from where I aimed it. So,
sure thing.
Not sure how much faith I can put in rockets. Not much. Well, I think it did drift by 2 tiles, but it was enough to really make sure we didn't do much, didn't put much hurt on them. Oh, I'm surprised that she hit, but there's so much grazing going on in this game. In Long War. Must look up how grazing works, whether it's outside of your hit percentage. I think it is outside your hit percentage. Oh, this is the first time we're seeing Advent use a grenade.
What's going on?
because I put two people close to each other. Now they're disoriented, and they won't be able to aim. Oh shit. Won't be able to aim well. I don't think they can use grenades either. Oh no!
Good.
Okay.
And all you got? I can
okay,
give it a try.
But yeah, no specials. Terrible aim. It's minus 11. Yeah, just they are useless to turn now because they were flashbanged. One's not great. And you do. Can't flank. I'm getting drawn too far apart now. Getting spread out too much. It hurts that they're flanked and useless. They can still move though. Not as far as normal, but move far enough. Brilliant. 41% to hit. Wasn't even gonna do enough damage necessarily, but she got it. I'll move her there. Maybe she can have a flank next time or something. Though he doesn't have a grenade, only a smoke. Kinda wanna try move her back in. Actually, if I move her back in, he can't see anyone, and then, well, if I move them as well, and I could possibly overwatch him.
If you say so. Overwatch!
So this is where, if he had the Gremlin Shock ability, I would definitely be using it, but he doesn't. Move to high cover. High cover where I won't be flanked. Or should I just stay there? This guy is flanked, but he can't see as far as this one. He will be running though, because he doesn't. As soon as I move this guy, the other guy will be tempted to run. Depending on where he runs, he could get more flanks. And there's not much point in me overwatching. Probably miss. I might just go safer, going back here, so he could come up and get a flank. Ooh, it's not good. This might be the best place to go. But not if that guy survives that overwatch. I could add an overwatch to it. I do have armor, but we're in for a long, long mission of enemies, I think. We've already used up a rocket and a grenade, or a rocket and a flame.
Got it covered.
Keep him on the high ground, overwatching.
Come get some.
Absolutely.
Oh crap, you can still be seen by him. The whole point was that you would move and not be seen. Oops. civilian runs away yelling. I think that'll bring more enemies to us, I'm not sure though. You would think so. Oh, look, more enemies. Hey! We never even saw a sectoid yet. And I guess this is a sectoid? Yeah, there's something weird going on there. Nice. Can someone else hit him for one? No. Oh no, get him! Crap, now he's flanking you.
Target's still up.
I need a med kit here.
Crap. So that's not fair that a sectoid is sending zombies at us without even seeing us. Probably kill them, maybe. But that's weak. Have to reload. Crap. Could grenade the guy, but... More so because of the sectoid thing, we were doing fine against this one small group. There are only two of them left. Now we've got two guys in high cover, one of them overwatching, and zombies. Although the zombies won't be with us too soon. Could just take shots. Actually, I think I could take two shots at him. Maybe.
Close.
Yeah. Hope we don't waste all our shots on him. I hope someone kills him. Ah.
I'll get him next time.
She's marked, so if he gets a shot on her, he'll probably hit her. I don't think he can get a shot on her until she reaches here, and so I don't think he'll shoot. Yeah. 14% is crap, but come on. Yeah! I thought we just missed enough shots that we were bound to hit that one. Stupid logic, but... Probably shouldn't have done that, because now he can flank her. Again, not taking it terribly seriously. Now the sectoid shows up. So yeah, Impregnable, that's another 5. And there's another 5 over there. That's 10 new soldiers in one go. Still dealing with one from before. Wow, Impregnable really means Impregnable. Well, now everybody knows. I think if we flashbang the sectoid, the zombies will go down. Yeah, now he's flanking. Crap. Oh, he had to reload. Sweet. You can get some flanks. Right. Whoa, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. And that's not even to say that's all of them, because I don't think she can see him.
Wow.
So I could flashbang a lot of them at once. One of them's overwatching. Our best shot is probably to do that. I think the zombies will go down. But she's flanked, so I need to rescue her somehow. Although he can't move while all that overwatch is there, but yeah, he could probably get the flank. Oh! This is a really interesting battle that I had no intention of getting into. But am in. It'd be great to get the sectoid and this guy, but we'll have to make do. 1, 2, 3. I kind of flashed 6 of them? Or 7? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. The zombies go down? Yeah, great. That felt like an amazing flashbang. Okay. Will he be overwatched as he moves? I think so. But I've got to rescue her.
It's worth it.
No, he wasn't. God!
I got nothing.
Crap.
Could use some ammo over here. Let's do this.
Not great. Sniper can't move and shoot. Yeah, so now nobody can actually hit that target, I think. Even if she went all the way out of cover. That's too far. Oh, she's in trouble. She put a great grenade out, but not good enough. Or at least her teammates let her down, let's say that. So I could actually launch another grenade.
Absolutely.
Wish I had loads of rockets. Rockets are lovely. Oh, I'm only throwing the frag grenade, I'm not a grenadier. I know, that's not gonna reach. Nope.
Enemy still up! On reserves!
Did some damage. Pretty much 56 on everybody, except the last few 41s. So if I hit anyone for 4 damage, I'd kill them, including the sectoid. It's probably a good one to get rid of. Although flashbang, he's only gonna shoot and he'll miss. So if I could shoot at someone who isn't... Yeah, he's not, flashbanged. Oh wait, he was, never mind. And I didn't kill him. So now she can't shoot on the next turn. I was counting on killing him and then reloading, so now she doesn't have a shot on the next turn. So many enemies. Impregnable really means impregnable.
Taking heavy fire.
Wow, he's really going for a flank.
I can't move.
think she's gonna take a lot of shots that miss, but probably some of them will hit. Oh yeah. Overwatch ready for anything? What does that mean? One of the special long war abilities, but is that where they can overwatch if you shoot? Because that's called something else for the XCOM bonuses. Maybe Advent, it's their equivalent, but...
I don't feel so good.
God. I'm gonna nuke the whole area. Lots of Overwatch.
That all you got?
I'm amazed that she's still alive, but... Flanks. I'd love to get up here with a flamethrower. Not to be. I could hollow target someone. I need her to reload and then do something, which is probably just gonna be hollow target someone. I'm surprised she can hollow target outside of her like, she's not using a sniper scope to hollow target. She's got a special pistol type thing, but she can hollow target anyone outside of her own view through squad sights. That's unexpected. Okay, can you pull this guy, please? No, you really can't. You suck at killing. Gremlin cancels Overwatch on targeted unit used 3 times per battle. That might be good. Let's cancel his Overwatch, though I don't think we really need to trigger anyone's Overwatch. Alright. Grenades out, maybe? Grenades would also cancel Overwatch. To get some kills.
Grenade out!
Really need to save her from the flank though. She's the only one who can reach all these people. Again, this is an alternate timeline. I'm not really counting consequences. We just wanted to play an Impregnable mission to see what Impregnable really means. Didn't plan to finish it or to count it. Crap, no one can kill that guy still. Yeah. 28 aim on him. I could hollow target. Oh no, I can't hollow target him because the sniper can't see her. Take 2 shots, or I could flank and shoot, I think. Trigger an Overwatch? No. Wow, yeah, Impregnable. Another 5 troops. Amazing. Might as well go to the bloody end to be entertaining. See how many we can take with us. It has taught us, though, we're never going to do an Impregnable mission for real. Just stupid. Alright, who can we shoot at? can't see any of those guys. They're too far for him. We go here. See a few. I think I can flank anyone. So many targets. Hello, target the sectoid maybe and take a couple of shots. This increases the aim on him by 10. Pity the sniper couldn't shoot that turn. 34 now. The hollow target on the sniper only lasts for your turn, unfortunately. Can I see him from there? Yeah, I can see. So I'll go here and take another shot on the sectoid. At least we hold some high ground, but it's all low cover. And they have so many shots on us. Got him.
Big deal. Go. My weapon's bent.
Wait, that was the wrong sectoid. We shot a non-hollow targeted sectoid. Ah well. Flank? Ah.
I think I got some help.
Oh. Didn't think he could move close enough. Oh yeah. Panicking will help you. Yep, this is the turn where it all goes bad.
Someone help!
Don't be brutal. Oh, double moving. They could just take shots and kill us. They have enough shots that they can't really miss. We're in so much trouble. The sniper isn't even in cover, I think. Oh, she is now, actually. She is in cover. Oh! Yeah, you think? We've only the sniper left. Two of them are panicked, two of them are down. Sky Ranger takes 6 turns to arrive, so... let's just call it. Oh, is that count as her shot as well? No, she can still shoot. But with all those enemies, and her best shot is 56. So many targets to choose from. Couldn't even kill him.
It's still up.
That'd be brutal. Though they seem to not know what to do. Like, so many of them just double moving. He could have, machine gunner could have flanked and killed the guy here. Instead they had someone take a shot from miles away.
Right.
Yeah, it's looking good.
Damn that thing.
Yep. So, impregnable means impregnable. They're not joking around. Doesn't just mean a little difficult, it means you can't carry enough bullets to get this job done. Because we weren't even moving out and revealing. They just came to us. We didn't do a load of stupid dashes to reveal enemies. We did on the very first turn, but that was only one group. We dealt with them pretty okay. Oh, yeah. Everyone goes to bleeding out. No one's actually been killed outright yet. Thank God. Oh, good, we do get a turn. He's suppressed, so... Well, she would have really good aim on him if she weren't suppressed. Pity. Suppose I could run over here and grenade the guys. Although Overwatch will probably kill me. I'll just try it. We're dying anyway. Yeah, they always just go to bleeding out. That's worth noting. So I guess I'm never gonna have people. It seems like that's two went down in the other mission and four down so far. Oh wait, no, is this guy bleeding out? Is he just dead? And he's bleeding out as well. What happened to the 50% you had a minute ago? Ha! She hit an 11%. I could run her, but she's suppressed, so... And that Sky Ranger won't be there for 5 turns. Might as well reload.
Reloaded.
I wonder if they're gonna shoot through the floor before they get her. She'll fall to her death. Anyone just joining us, this is a experimental alternate timeline into what an impregnable mission means. Though it's not Iron Man mode, we did save before launching the impregnable mission. But eventually it means there are at least 30 enemies so far. It might have been 40. Always groups of 5.
Incoming over here!
Advent troops and sectoids.
I can't move!
There's so many shots on her. Just lucky so far.
Taking fire over here!
Well, probably should have requested evac on the first turn or something, but... So, now she's flanked, and he can't move and shoot, so she's pretty much gotta hit the guy up on her flank, or she's dead. 31%? Well, it's your life. And make sure you hit the shot. No, stop his foot right in front of you.
Adjusting sights.
It's the end of you. Imagine this later in the game, an impregnable mission when they've got sectoids and andromedons and stuff. Just in no way. I think if I had a fully upgraded squad, I could probably tackle this. There we go. Just about.
XCOM operatives are dead or MIA. I'm returning to base.
Yeah, just crazy. Okay, 28 enemies. So impregnable means 28 enemies, I guess. Give or take, it might be more or less sometimes. That's worth knowing about. We've seen what long war means by impregnable. We're not continuing, I just can't escape to reload. That's probably long enough for a stream, so makes sense to just revert in our timeline. I'm not going to do much of this at all. It's going to be, as you saw when we lost two troops earlier, I didn't reload or anything. I just wanted to see what an impregnable mission would be so we could all see it. But it, like, that'll screw my whole campaign. So that's why I saved before choosing to launch an impregnable mission that we would not launch in a sensible timeline. But yeah, the next time I play...
This one was ugly, Commander. Losses like that cost us more than just manpower.
Yep. And that was our A-team as well. Got nothing. Force under strength, you know, it's all bad. Manpower, Commander. So, I'll reload the impregnable... That was our save point just before we went on the impregnable timeline. So we'll go back to our normal, like the first half of this stream counts, the second half doesn't. And we'll go back to the main timeline and we won't revert that much. Occasionally I revert just to see what one move's worth of like a new weapon or something is, but I wanted to see what impregnable meant. I don't want to just wonder forever. And I doubt many people will try the impregnable. I thought it was worth doing. And it was kind of fun at first, and it was just inevitable. Once they brought 15 enemies back in two goes when we were already dealing with 8, I think, that was just the end of it. Okay, so the next time we stream, we're back to the normal timeline. Thanks for watching. Have a good evening, day, good night, whatever. Bye-bye.